Welcome back. So we are on the Scenic Byway over the Medicine Bow National Forest, 60-some miles east of Laramie. And this will be a video going over the pass and back down. It is 1:17 in the afternoon. 82 degrees outside, and we got fresh oil on the road. Oh, this is the North Platte River. Oh my gosh, I had no idea it started here. It starts in the those mountains I want to go through, basically. Wow, that is way cool. And look at the thunderstorm clouds in front of us. That is cool too. Everything's cool. Having a cool day. Pressure goes up to 40 psi. When you go downhill, it goes down to 29, literally like 2 or 3 seconds. First time it did that, it scared me because I never watched it, you know, to see how it reacted to when the engine works harder. So that's pretty interesting. For, I think it is. I need to quit looking at the diagnostics on the car. Side of the mountains. So we have 35 miles to cross these mountains. These are the mountains that have tons of stuff, like campgrounds, and I think there's a ski area, and just all kinds of stuff to do. Probably a lot of hiking trails, because it's so close to Laramie. Construction on these back roads this trip. So the one we're going over now is maybe an hour from Laramie to get like anywhere in the mountain range. another hour, you're in the Continental Divide Trail. That one. And you can go south to Walden. It takes like an hour in Colorado. There's a lot to do here. Then you got the little, I don't know if you call it mountains or hills, between Laramie and Cheyenne. There's got to be hiking trails there. I just want an affordable house someday. Of course, we have another plan that I don't want to talk about. But we will see what happens. As long as my wife wants to stay in Washington, we will stay in Washington. As long as I can do my trips like this. Right now, I go see my family, but eventually I want to do trips like this without seeing my family. She is doing the hiking thing with her really good friend, and I'm happy about that. Can't really do trips together anyway because of our cat, unless we want to take the trailer, which I don't like pulling the trailer when it costs so much for gas. I just don't like it. It's not fun. She doesn't care, but I'm like, I don't want to spend that much money. There's a glut of used trailers that nobody wants to buy because no one's, you know, there's so many people trying to sell them. And I don't want to talk about Herbie's trailer, so I'm going to drop this right now. You don't want to hear that. And I'm past being an RVer. No desire. A van or a truck. That's all I need. I will say, I've seen lots of Ford Transit vans on the dealer's lots finally. Forever, you never saw them, and now you finally are again. But I'm not in the market for one now, so that sucks. We have, the cars we have, we hope they last 8 to 10 years for each of, you know, before we need a new car. Going to drive these things until you can't drive them anymore, or it's, you know, it needs a new engine and that costs too much. Oh wow, look at the school bus way out here. And take the school bus. Scenic Byway. I need to remember that. Forgot to put my towels back up. Roads. Oh wow. Brush Creek Visitor Center to the left. showed a cross-country skiing sign and stuff, and hiking. Wow. Medicine Bow National Forest. Should have stopped there and got see if they had the maps, the really detailed maps, but I have to come through here on my back to get to that road, so I'll do that when I come back. Trucks to my right coming down that road, so they're logging parts of this forest. Picture of a tent, so I think it's, oh no, this is the Ryan Park campground. For a second I thought it was dispersed camping. Wow. So basically, when I travel across the country, if I want to camp for free or cheap, I have to get off the interstate to find all these campgrounds. That's what I learned from this trip. If you take the highway, you will find all these places. Yeah, they're just roads everywhere. Wow. Ugh, looking at the map now. So, the infotainment screen is kind of a distraction when you're driving. But it's not against the law to use it, like your cell phone. Nice to get a thunderstorm. I think that was Saratoga back there. That's what's coming up on my weather app. 81 degrees. And the only the thunderstorms in my direction are to the north and south of Laramie. Side roads. all sandy, like sandy roads, it looks like, you know, with little gravel maybe. It's really nice to drive on, it looks like. Storm in front of us. So that is basically north of Laramie, that thunderstorm. It's probably 50 miles away. Day just driving around these roads on the Forest Service roads on this mountain. Probably, and you wouldn't even see close to half of them. Not even probably 20% of them or 10% of them. There's so many. There's a lot of dead trees now. I think it's from bug kill insects. Oh, that's sad. This would be sad to see a forest fire here. It doesn't look like it's had one for a long time. That kind of looks like snow up there, those rocks. I don't think it is. It snowed overnight. It hasn't melted yet. It's pretty white. Thank you. just white rocks. It's such an odd color. It almost has some pink in it, it looks like. This looks like Colorado. You would think you're in Colorado. Wyoming has some amazing mountains, and they're all over different areas of the state. I can't believe, like, so few people live here. Wow, so to the left, looks like there's dispersed camping. I'm not sure what's going on down there. Turn the AC off, put the windows down. Cool, the camera off. Campground up here. Wow, this would be nice. Silver Lake Campground. But that is awesome. Oh wow, it's got a ton of people down there. Almost looks like dispersed camping. Can't really tell. Wow, this is an incredible view. Vista Point, Silver Lake. Probably the pass, and there's no elevation sign, which is weird. Maybe it's not. Oh god, there's so many dead trees out there. It's gonna be devastating if they get a lightning strike. I bet there's places where 50 to 75% of the trees are dead, it looks like. I think we're going down. They just don't tell you what the elevation is at the top. All the time. Don't get it. 65 degrees now. So somewhere there's a ski area around here. It's probably on the north side when we go down. Oh wow, that's a massive, there's a massive summits in front of us still. Jeez. This is neat. The Tipple Trailhead. Wow, look at all the snow. This is really popular right here. Way cool. You walk down a canyon on the one side, and there was like a creek you follow, and then there's a lake on the other side. Oh, this is incredible. You could be in Washington here. Never know the difference. It's another trail on the right, on the left. Shoot, why go to Rocky Mountain National Park when it's so busy? You can come here and hike any day. Yeah, I gotta tell my sister's husband. Before I drove through yesterday, I told her he should come here because I looked at the map. But now that I've driven through here, I've seen at least 3 or 4 trailheads just right here. He could come here for, one trip at least. There's gotta be more that I'm not seeing too yet. So there's a bunch of lakes back there where those trails were. Feel like I'm in the mountains south of Billings, Montana. They all start to look the same, I guess, after a while. Oh, I could totally live in Laramie now. So before, when I wanted to live in Laramie, it was because it was close to Colorado Mountains, Walden, and housing was affordable. I had no idea this was this close. We're literally, I bet we're 30 to 40 miles from Laramie right here. That's it. I mean, this is awesome. Here's an overlook. Oh, I can't imagine all the snow up here in the winter. We haven't even made it to the ski area turnoff yet. Oh wow, here's another overlook on the right. You look down into the valley that the interstate's in Laramie. We are really up there. It's called Libby Flats. Observation points. Super cool. So Sugarloaf Recreation Area is on the road to the left, and it has camping and hiking trails. Yeah, he's got to come up here. This is just way cool. Oh, actually want to spend some time here when I go drive back home, I think, now that I know about this. Here's a trailhead. Green Rock, it's called. It looks like there's another one on the left here. So there are trails at the bottom. Or as you go down. Ski area to the right. I hope we can see it. I wanted to see what it looks like. Not sure how far down the road it is. Oh, I don't think it's very big. I see a little, at least one patch of grass. Yeah, it's not huge. It's not bad though. I mean, I wonder if it has 15, 20 trails. Can't tell, like, I don't know if there's any trails on the south side though. There could be trails on the south side of the mountain. It would be fun. So the transmission fluid went back out to 176. So I think mid-170s is normal operating temperature when you're not stressing it from climbing hills. There's a campground down Barber Lake Road. So many campgrounds. When I come back this way, I will check out the side roads, because I probably won't film this road again unless there's something really cool about it, like rain, thunderstorms, you know. Oh, there's National Forest information on the left. Oh, there's a little ranger station here. Awesome. It's a visitor center. I will stop here when I come back. It'll be a Thursday or Friday. Wow. Just like that, you're out of the forest. I am so glad I drove through that. So I have 11 days I could take when I go back home to Washington. I'm gonna need those 11 days, I think. A lot of stuff I want to see. I could spend 2 or 3 days, at least 2 days, just in this part of Wyoming. Another day or two up by Yellowstone and driving through stuff. So probably like 3-4 days in Wyoming, easy, I could spend. 3 to 4 days.
In a quarter mile, you will arrive at your destination.
Oh, this is Centennial, population 283. Wow, we're at 8,000 feet still. So we must have been at like 10 or 11,000 feet up there. If we're 8,000 here. That's crazy. I gotta see what the elevation of that place was. I'll have to go to their website. Jeez. Bear Bottom Bar and Grill. I love little towns like this. Old Corral Hotel and Steakhouse. Jeez. Pretty cool. Centennial Depot. It's a historical depot. Yeah, I need to bring my wife out here. Like, we could just come to Southeast Wyoming for a vacation. Be fun. So Laramie's at 27 miles. You're 27 miles from all of that if you live in Laramie. I just can't get over that. Video. I was driving over the Medicine Bow Mountains. Thanks for watching.